Hello guys, how are you? Welcome to GeoMind. This is the part second of Carboniferous period of the video series Geological Time Scale. So in the previous video series, we have talked about the paleogeography, paleoclimate, okay, introduction to time scale of Carboniferous period, okay, and the formation of Pangaea, how the formation of Pangaea started. Okay, the Appalachian and Alleghenian orogeny, we have talked about it. So in today's video, we will talk about the life during the Carboniferous period, that is vertebrates and invertebrates, also the evolution of amniotes, that is egg laying reptiles, okay, that laid egg in the terrestrial environment. Also we will talk about the minor extinction event, that is rainforest collapse, Carboniferous rainforest collapse that happened in the Pennsylvanian. Okay, then there is coal deposits, okay, and some important life form of Carboniferous period. So first, there are two questions as usual, so you have to write the answer in the comment. Okay, name the second largest mass extinction out of these four, and you have to in the second question you have to answer the out of these two, nautilites and ammonites, which came earlier. Okay, so you have to write the age and the name of either nautilites or ammonite. Okay, so let's start with the life. In vertebrate life, if you talk about invertebrate life, the Devonian extinction caused limitation of corals, so such as corals such as rugosa and horn tabulata were limited, and thus reef forming, the reef were not present in the Carboniferous period, or they were limited or poorly developed. Benthic community were dominated by crinoids. So crinoids look something like this. They are echinoderms and they are stalked and has a flower-like structure. Bryozoans, brachiopods were present. If you talk about the brachiopods, all orders were present except Pentamerida. Okay. Now talking about the microfossils such as Foraminifera, fusillinids came in the Carboniferous period and they became extinct during the Permian. Fusillinids are the benthic foraminifera. Okay, trilobites, rugose corals are also known as horn corals, nautiloids, ammonoids, graptoloids, okay, were present. By the way, we have talked about the graptolite morphology in the previous videos. So dendroids are type of graptoloids which have tree branch like structure. They were extinct in the Mississippian, while our usual graptoloids were extinct in the Devonian. Okay, there was a great diversification of insects. Okay, so as you know, insects live in terrestrial environment, but there were no flying insect known from Mississippian. So in early Carboniferous period, there was no flying insect, but in Pennsylvanian, flying insects such as Meganeura is a type of giant dragonfly. Okay, they appeared, and also their size were huge. We will talk about this in later part of the video, that how the scorpions, centipedes were huge due to the rise in oxygen levels. Talking about the vertebrates, fishes were present, but placoderms were extinct. Okay, jawed fishes were extinct, while jawed fishes, by placoderms I mean the armored jawed fishes. Okay, their jaw were not of bone but rather an armored structure. Okay, while chondrichthyes are cartilage fishes such as shark, and osteichthyes are your typical bony fishes. They were present throughout the Carboniferous period. Kaleidoscalache is a type of a primitive shark and it dominated the marine setting. If we talk about the amphibians, as you know, the Carboniferous period is also known as the age of amphibians. Okay, so you have to remember this, and this was the peak time of diversification for amphibians. So they were present, such as Labiae, Debritodont, Pedapes, Proterogyrinus, and the first amniotes came in Carboniferous periods. So this was one of the greatest revolutionary moment in the geological history of Earth, was the appearance of Hylonomus. So it was a tetrapod that laid eggs in the terrestrial environment. Okay, so in previously the amphibians were laying eggs in the aquatic environment. Okay, and then during the maturation period of amphibians, they live in the terrestrial environment. But Hylonomus, a amniote, it laid eggs in the drier environment and its eggs were shelled. So that's why the eggs were able to survive in the dry environment. So this was a huge leap forward in the evolutionary history of mammals, okay, and all other animals that will come during the later part of the geological time scale. So laying eggs in the dry environment allowed for the further exploitation of land by certain tetrapods, and these tetrapods, lizard like, quickly gave rise to reptiles. Okay, so as these tetrapod gave rise to reptiles due to the these eggs, okay, shelled eggs, these reptiles will then give rise to birds and mammals. Okay, so this is a beautiful chart of evolution, that how fishes evolved, lower fin fishes evolved to tetrapods, and then tetrapods evolved to amniotes and amphibians. Amniotes laid eggs in dry environment, and this branched off to synapsids and diapsids. So synapsids are us like mammals, okay, mammal like reptiles, or this is a mammal like reptiles, okay, or mammals, while diapsids are our dinosaurs, non-flying dinosaurs, our birds, crocodiles, okay. And diapsids have two branches, archosaurs and lepidosaurs. Lepidosaurs are our lizards, okay, snakes. So that's how amniotes evolved. Okay, so that's why the evolution of amniotes during the Carboniferous period is important, because it's our common ancestor of dinosaurs, humans, okay, lions, name it all. And also this is a beautiful graphic. You can see the vertebrates, then tetrapods comes under the fish lineage, and from these tetrapods amniotes evolved, from amniotes synapsids evolved. Okay, synapsids are what, animals with one hole behind the eye, okay, and diapsids are animals with two holes behind the eye, such as lizards and crocodiles, and mammals have only one hole behind their eye. Talking about the plants, Carboniferous terrestrial environment was dominated by vascular plants, and the trees were huge, almost 30 meter in heights, and calamites, sigillaria, okay, lepidodendron, horsetails, these were flourishing during the Carboniferous period, and these later formed the extensive coal deposits. Talking about the minor extinction event that happened during the Carboniferous period was Carboniferous rainforest collapse. Okay, so it is a minor extinction event that happened in the Pennsylvania, that is in if we talk about late Carboniferous period. Okay, so about 305 million years, climate shifted from steamy and tropical to dry. So as you know, rainforests are in steamy and tropical portion of, you could say, Earth. But as this steamy and tropical climate shifted to dry, the rainforest collapsed. Okay, so this event happened in contribution of large coal deposit. Okay, helped in contribution of large coal deposits. So earlier animals were cosmopolitans. So during the rainforest, okay, when the rainforest was present there in the Mississippian, animal used to roam all around the continent. But as the rainforest collapsed, there was less forest, less trees, and the rainforest was in patches, okay, small patches. Okay, so these are the rainforest, you can say, and this is the dry area. So as these patches came into existence, okay, unique species in each patch, okay, so endemism happened, each patch had their unique species, okay. Thus, the climate became less hospitable for amphibians. So amphibians, as you know, love to live in steamy, or you could say tropical type of environment. And amphibians became almost extinct, and the rise of reptiles. So reptiles, you can say, are accustomed to live in the dry environment. Okay, so landscape was cooler and drier. And this was one of the main reason for rise in amniotes. Okay, A collapse caused oxygen level to fall, thus rise in dwarfism. So as if the oxygen will fall, the size will shrink and dwarfism will happen. So giant arthropods such as Arthropleura and Meganeura became extinct due to low level of oxygen. And the cause of this rainforest collapse, there are various hypothesized causes such as glaciation, sea level fall and volcanism. Talking about the coal deposit, as you know, the Carboniferous coal deposit are very famous and they provide much fuel for the power generation during the Industrial Revolution that happened, okay, for almost 200 years. And still in the today's world, coal is the major source of fuel, especially for the developing countries such as India and China. In addition, major accumulation of oil and natural gas is associated with the strata of Carboniferous period. So this marks the importance of Carboniferous period. Okay, these large coal deposit owe their significance to a major factor, two major factor. So why these coal deposit occurred in the first place? First was the appearance of lignin. Okay, so lignin is nothing, it is a wood fiber. Okay, sorry, wood fiber, and this lignin is very resistant to decay. Okay, so as the wood will not decay, there will be much chance of wood altering into coal. Okay, and second was the lower sea level. Okay, so as the sea level is low, there will be land for plenty of land for extensive swamps and the forest in northern hemisphere. Okay, these two are the major causes. Also, during that time, the decomposing bacteria were not evolved. Okay, so they didn't have enzymes, and that's why the wood was not able to decay. Okay, so this could be major cause. So fungi that could effectively break lignin polymers only evolved toward the end of the period. Okay, so if you talk about the today's world, if a plant or a tree falls, it get decayed immediately due to organism, okay, microorganism or fungi. But at that time, the microorganism and the fungi were not evolved. Okay, they didn't have enzymes to decay the wood, so the wood had a much better chance of altering into coal. As if you talk about today, the forest, if a forest collapse or the plant collapse, it has a very low chance of forming into coal deposit. Okay, so briefly you can say, as a result, undegraded carbon built up. Okay, so if the wood is not decaying, the carbon will remain in the wood and the fixed carbon will get buried, increasing the oxygen level. Okay, so if the wood will not decay, the carbon present in the wood will not, you could say, spew out in the atmosphere. Okay, so this might be the major cause of oxygen level in the Carboniferous period. Now let's talk about some major life forms that were present during the Carboniferous period. So this creature you see here is the Meganeura. Meganeura was a giant dragonfly and it was a huge insect. It has a wingspan of 70 centimeter, and you can see its size, okay, compared to a modern man. Okay, so classic example of high levels of oxygen, what a high level of oxygen could do to an insect. Okay, now this is Arthropleura, one of the largest terrestrial arthropods. Okay, and it was almost 9 feet in length, was probably a herbivore. Okay, so was very terrifying. Then there is Pulmonoscorpius. It was also a very giant scorpion. Okay, almost you could say 2 feet in length. Then there is Pedapes, earliest known tetrapod. Then there is Archaeothyrus, oldest known synapsid, okay, ancestor of modern mammals. Okay, there is a difference between diapsid and synapsid. And this is Hylonomus, the earliest reptile, okay, or earliest amniote, you could say. So thank you, that's it for Carboniferous period. Please like, share and